Hi students, welcome to yet another session of my class. We are discussing the paper Word Classics. In the last class we discussed about the syllabus and defined the term classics. I think all of you are familiar with this particular paper and understand the term classics, that is what do you mean by classics, or how can we define this term classics and what we are going to study in this particular paper. I think all of you are familiar with this particular term, that is classics, and the meaning and definition of classics. Today we are going to discuss about the characteristic features of literary classics or some qualities of classical literature. Let us discuss it. Yes, a classic piece of literature must have a number of qualities. Why these literary pieces are classic in term? Why we call this as a classic one? Because a classic piece of literature must have a number of qualities, and let us discuss in detail what are the important qualities of these literary classics. And the first one is, a classic expresses artistic beauty. That means classic literature is an expression of life, truth and beauty. Yes, a classic piece of literature, it is a true expression of or representation of life, truth and beauty. A classic piece of literature must be of high quality, at least for the time in which it was written. That means a classic piece of literature, it should maintain that high quality and can be appreciated for its construction and literary art. That's why we call it as a classic one. For example, Odyssey, Virgil's Aeneid. We consider all these works as a classic one, classic literature. That is Antigone by Sophocles. Why? Because it is an expression, it is a true expression of life, truth and beauty, and moreover, it accorded a high quality standard and can be appreciated for its construction and literary art. Then the second one is, a classic stands the test of time. That means a classic is timely. A classic work is usually considered to be a representation of a period in which it was written. Normally, all literary productions are the representation of that age. But in the case of classic works, usually they are considered to be a representation of a period in which it was written. And the important thing is, the work merits lasting recognition. That's why we call it as a classic one. Because, yes, it either shows or influences the times in which it was written, and moreover, a classic not only relates to the time it was written in, but is also timeless. That means transcends the ages. The work merits lasting recognition. And a classic connects authors and times. It reveals influences from other writers and other great works of literature. And a classic is both a product of its own time, that is the representation of its own period or age, and a unique expression of it. For example, Uncle Tom's Cabin is a famous work, and it opened the eyes of America to the dark side of slavery. Through that particular classical work, that is Uncle Tom's Cabin, it opened the eyes of America to the dark side of slavery. And Oliver Twist, you all are familiar with this work, Oliver Twist by Charles Dickens. So Oliver Twist showed the difficult lives of the homeless children in England, etc. That period, especially that the difficult lives of the homeless children in England, that is depicted in that particular work. These two are examples. That means a classic stands the test of time, and moreover, it should be a representation of a period. These are two best examples. That is Uncle Tom's Cabin and Oliver Twist. And a classic not only relates to the time it was written in, but it is also timeless. Then, third one is a classic has a certain universal appeal. Great works of literature touch readers to their very core beings, partly because they integrate themes that are understood by readers from a wide range of backgrounds and levels of experiences. Great works of literature touch readers deeply because they integrate themes that are understood by readers from a wide range of backgrounds and levels of experiences. That means they dealt with a wide range of themes, backgrounds, and other levels of experiences. That is theme of love, hate, death, life, and faith touch upon some of our most basic emotional responses. That's why, yes, we can say that a classic has a certain universal appeal because great works of literature touch readers to their very core because they integrate themes that range from all backgrounds, all level of experiences, and it should be readers can easily understood. And a classic should deal with the themes that touch all periods of history, all societies and all cultures. The themes relate many different people also, and some such main ideas include good versus evil, love and forgiveness, success against all odds and personal values, etc. So a classic has a certain universal appeal. That means the themes relate many different people, and moreover it touch all periods of history, all societies and all cultures. Next point is a classic makes connections. That means a classic is always influenced by other writers and great works of literature. This is somewhat related to the universality of classics. A classic is informed by the history of ideas and literature. Also, a classic inspires other writers who come after it. A classic is always influenced by other writers and great works of literature, and moreover it is informed by the history of ideas and literature. And also a classic inspires other writers, that is it also inspires the later writers, that is the writers who come after it. That is a classic makes connections here in the sense establishing connection between the antiquity and the present form. Then real classics present truth. Next one, real classics present truth. Yes, any author can develop a story so that evil appears inevitable, lying pace of hate and revenge are good, etc. However, though these responses to life might seem justified at times, they never pays off long run. A classic work will still be recognized for its literary value a long time after it is first published. In this sense, we can see that a best example, can you say a best example for this? That is Shakespeare's writing. We can say that Shakespeare's writing is true classic as it transcends the ages. So real classics always present truth. That's why a classic work will still be recognized because of its literary value that is existing after it is first published. and moreover a true classic must have been around for a while. Next point is a classic is readable in its style. Real classics are not poorly written. Variety is possible. The story in a classic almost tells itself, though not without surprises. The characters are deep and believable. A classic story will not preach a moral but will illustrate a lesson by hiding it in the story. Yes, a classic story will not preach a moral but will illustrate a lesson by hiding it in the story. So a classic is readable in its style. That is, the characters are believable even in their depth. That is the point here. The characters are believable even in their depth. This is exemplified in Shakespeare's Hamlet. We can say a good example, that is Hamlet, Shakespeare. Here the author does not tell you how to feel or what conclusions to draw. Instead, the reader can feel or conclude what they want. The story does not come right out and tell the reader a theme, but shows a moral or theme so that the message is clear even though it is hidden in the story. I think all of you understand this point. A classic is readable in its style. And the next one is a classic connects authors and times. That means you can study a classic and discover influences from other writers and other great works of literature, etc. At once, a classic both expresses the period and style and struggles of the time and uniquely stands on its own. That is another point. That is, a classic connects authors and times. So let us conclude the point. That is, the Western classical tradition is the reception of classical Greco-Roman antiquity by later cultures. Once again, I repeat, Western classical tradition. The Western classical tradition is the reception or receiving of classical Greco-Roman. We all know that this Greek literature and Roman literature is famous for antiquity. So, classical qualities. So, this Western classical tradition is the reception or the receiving of this classical Greco-Roman antiquity. Antiquity in this sense means traditional language, philosophy, etc. That is before Middle Ages. So, reception or receiving of classical Greco-Roman antiquity by later cultures, especially the post-classical West. And it involves texts, imagery, objects, ideas, institutions, monuments, architecture, cultural artifacts, rituals, practices and sayings. Then philosophy, political thought and mythology are three major examples of how classical culture survives and continues to have influence. Yes, philosophy, political thought and mythology. These three are the major examples of how this classical culture survives and transcends the ages and continues to have influence on later writers, readers, etc. These three are the major examples, that is philosophy, political thought and mythology. All these have, yes, influence upon later writers, readers, etc. So these three are the major examples of how classical culture survives and how it continues and how it influences the later writers or works, other works, etc. I think all of you understand this session. That is, qualities of literary classics. That is, some of the important characteristic features of literary classics. I think all of you understand this session, and there is a homework for you, and the homework is write about the qualities of literary classics or the characteristic features of literary classics. Write your homework and send back to me through WhatsApp. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you again.